Hello guys, welcome to another video by Supreme Tuber. In this video we will be discussing Routh Hurwitz stability criterion. Okay, let's assume a transfer function CS by RS B0 S key n, B1 S key power n minus 1, B2 S key power n minus 2 and so on up to Bn. Okay, upon A0 S key power n. Okay, so let's assume this transfer function. Okay, we have to check its stability by using Routh Hurwitz stability criterion. Okay, so whatever transfer function is given to you, you will only look at the denominator. Okay, you will only look at the denominator. You don't have to look at the numerator. It is none of our concern. Okay, so this is our denominator. If we equate the denominator to zero, we get an equation which is called characteristic equation. So the characteristic equation of this transfer function TS is A0 Sn plus A1 S key power n minus 1 plus up to An equal to 0. Okay, so this is the characteristic equation of this transfer function. Okay, so after we have got the characteristic equation, there are two conditions which we have to check to see if the system is unstable or stable. If we find that the system is stable, we further check to see if it is complete, if it is stable properly, because the first two criterion which we will study only tells us if the system is not unstable. It doesn't make us too sure if the system is stable. Okay, you will get what I am saying. I'll just write down 2 points here. So these are the two conditions that I was talking about. All the coefficients of the equation should have same sign, which means that A0, A1, A2, A3 up to An should have same sign. Either all of them should have a plus sign or all of them should have a negative sign. Okay, so this is the first condition. Okay, these conditions are necessary but not sufficient condition for stability. That means that these conditions are must for a system to be stable, but if these conditions are satisfied, we are not completely sure that if the system is stable. Okay, and the second condition is there should not be any missing term. Okay, which means that if suppose we have the characteristic equation is like this, S3 plus S2 plus S1 plus S0. Okay, there should not be any missing term, which means that all the powers of n should be present in a sequence. Okay, decreasing sequence, increasing sequence, all the power should be present. Okay, it should not be like this, first n is given, then n minus 2 is given, n minus 1 term is not given. That equation can't be stable. For stability, there should not be any missing term. Okay, there should not be any missing term. If the above two conditions are not satisfied, then the system is unstable. But if all the coefficients have the same sign and no missing term, then we have no guarantee that the system is stable. Then we use Routh Hurwitz stability criterion. Routh Hurwitz criteria states that for a closed loop system to be stable, it is necessary and sufficient that all elements of the first column of Routh array must have the same sign. If no row of Routh array results into all zero elements. Okay. So I'll show you what I just said. Routh Hurwitz criteria states that for a closed loop system to be stable, it is necessary and sufficient that all the elements of the first column of Routh array, this term is important, Routh array must have same sign if no row of Routh array results into zero elements. Now I will teach you Routh array. Okay, suppose we have a transfer. I will teach you Routh array using a question. Okay, suppose we have a transfer function TS is equal to CS by RS is equal to S upon S4 plus 8 S cube plus 8 S square plus 16 S plus 5. Okay, so suppose this is our question and we have to check the stability of the system using Routh Hurwitz criterion. Okay, so first we will write the characteristic equation of the system. Okay, So this is the characteristic equation of this transfer function. Okay, after writing the characteristic equation, we check if the system is unstable or not. Okay, so that we don't have to go into making the Routh array. Okay, so for unstability, these two conditions should not be satisfied. But here we see that coefficients of all the terms have same sign and all the terms are present. S4 is present, S3 is present, S2 is present, S1 is present, and S0 is also present. Okay, so all the terms are present and all the coefficients have same sign. That means that the system is not unstable. Okay, system is not unstable. See how I carefully choose my words. Okay, system is not unstable. We are not yet completely sure if the system is stable or not. For checking the stability of the system, we go using the Routh array. So for using the Routh array, you will write all the terms of S column wise. Okay, so write like this: S4, S3, S2, S1, S0. Okay, then draw a line like this. Okay, so we are now making the Routh array. Okay, I will write it here, Routh array. Okay, so this is our Routh array. For filling the first row of Routh array, you can see the power of S is even here. Okay, even power. So we will write the coefficients of all the coefficients of all the terms with even power, like S4 is even, S2 is even, S3 is odd. Okay, S4 is even, S2 is even, S0 is even. So we will write the coefficients row wise of these three terms in S4, because 4 is even, so we will write even terms coefficient. So the coefficient of S4 is 1, the coefficient of next term is 8, the coefficient of next term is 5. For filling the second row, the coefficient of S3 is odd, the coefficient of this the starting term of this row is odd. Okay, so I will write the coefficients of all the odd terms here. There are two odd terms. Okay, 8, first odd term is 8, second odd term is 16. Okay, as I don't have any other thing here, I will write 0 here. Okay, 0. For filling the third row, now here comes the problem. Okay, here is the real deal starting. Okay, so first two rows will always be filled like in this fashion. Okay, in this fashion, first we fill, suppose the first row is odd. Okay, suppose it is S5, then we fill all the odd coefficients here, then even coefficients in the next row. The first two rows are always filled in this fashion. Okay, for third row we go like this. Okay, first we multiply these two terms. Okay, 8 into 8, I'll write it here, 8 into 8, these two terms. Okay, these two terms, first draw a arrow in the cross direction. Okay, for your understanding. Okay, now multiply these two terms from which are going from the left side. You can consider you can learn this as left punch, right punch, left punch, right punch. 8 into 8 minus 16 into 1. Okay, divided by this term 8. Okay, so this is 64 minus 16 by 8, which is 6. Okay, so I will write 6 here. Okay, 6 here. How I did how I wrote 6? First I multiplied this term by this term into this term, going in this direction of arrow. Then I subtracted the multiplication of these two terms going in this direction. Okay, then I divided by first term. Okay, 8 into 8 divided by minus 1 into 16 divided by 8. Okay, for writing the term here, I will again go like this, but this time I will go for this column. Okay, I will refer these two columns for writing this element. Okay, I will go like this: 8 into 5 minus, now you think what will be here? These two columns are being considered. When these two columns were being considered, it was like this and this. Now these two columns were being considered, so it is like this and this. Okay, this and this. Okay, 8 into 5 minus 0 into 1 divided by the term which will be divided by will remain same. Okay, so this is equal to 5. So I write 5 here. For writing the term which is present here, I consider another row, another column of 0 0. Now I go like this, considering these two. Okay, 8 into 0 minus 0 into 1 divided by this term again 8, which is 0. Okay, so I have drawn 3. Now for writing this, row, I will take these two columns. For writing this row, I took these two columns under consideration. Okay, for writing this row, I will take these two columns under consideration. Okay, for writing the first term of this column, I will do like this, 6 into 16 minus 5 into 8 divided by this term this time. Okay, this term, which is 6 into 16 minus 8 into 5 divided by 6. Okay, which is 9.33. okay, so I will write 9.33 here. Now for writing this term, I will consider these two rows are being considered. Now for writing, I do like this, 6 into 0 minus 0 into 8 divided by 6, which is 0. Similarly, 0 here. Similarly, you can fill out these terms. Okay, for filling out these term, I do 9.33 into 5 minus 0 into 6 divided by 9.33, which is 5. Okay, 0 0. Okay, so I have formed the Routh array. Okay, so this is the Routh array of this characteristic equation, which was formed from this transfer function. Okay, so after I have formed the Routh array, we will again look into the definition of Hurwitz polynomials. States that for a closed loop transfer function, it is necessary to be insufficient that all the elements of first column of Routh array must have same sign. All the elements must have same sign. You can see here, all the elements are having same sign. So that means the transfer function is stable, definitely stable. So now I will teach you a few questions on Routh stability to make the concept more crystal clear. But before that, I'm just gonna breeze you real quick through what I did in this question. Okay, so the transfer function of this question was given. I wrote the characteristic equation by only considering by equating the denominator to zero. After I wrote the characteristic equation, I checked these two conditions in the characteristic equation: all the coefficients must have same sign and no term must be absent. After I checked these two conditions, I went for Routh array. For writing Routh array, I wrote all these terms column wise. Then for filling the first two rows of this array, I wrote even and odd terms. Okay, then for filling this row, I used these two rows. Okay, for filling this row, I used these two rows, and so on. Okay, so the next question for Routh stability is, so guys, suppose we are given a transfer function such that its characteristic equation is this, sq plus s square plus 3s plus 5. We have to check the stability of this transfer function. So we will use this characteristic equation. Okay, let's assume this is the characteristic equation. Just imagine. Okay, so first we check that all the terms have positive coefficients of same sign and no term is absent. Okay, so this system is not unstable. Okay, after I have checked that the system is not unstable, I draw the Routh array. For drawing the Routh array, I write all these terms. I write all these terms column wise. Okay, all these s cube, s square, s, s zero. Okay, now for filling the first two rows, you see the power of the s term. Okay, the power is odd, so fill the coefficients of all the odd terms. The power is even, so fill the coefficients of all the even terms. After I filled the coefficient, for writing the row containing the s element, I use 1 into 3 minus 5 into 1. 1 into 3 minus 5 into 1. Sorry, 1 into 3 minus 5 into 1, which is minus 2, divided by this element 1, which is minus 2. Okay, minus 2 minus 2. Okay, for filling out this element, 1 into 0 minus 0 into 1 divided by 1, 0. For filling out this element, 1 into 0 minus 0 into 1 divided by 1, which is 0. Similarly, I filled out S0, 500. Now, for the system to be stable, all the elements of first row, all the elements of the first column must be positive. Sorry, not positive, must have the same sign. Okay, they must have the same sign, but here we can see that the sign is different. Okay, so if the sign is different, the system is unstable, and the number of times the sign changes will tell us how many roots thus this equation has in the right half plane. You can see that the characteristic equation has a power of 3. So this equation, so this transfer function has a total of 3 roots in the S plane. Okay, so you can see if we go from here to here, we have 1 sign change and 2 sign change. Okay, plus to minus, then minus to plus, 2 sign changes are there, 3 roots, out of which 2 are in right half plane because we have 2 sign changes. Total roots are 3, 2, therefore 2 poles in the right half and 1 is in the left plane. Okay, so the number of sign changes tells us how many roots are there in the right half of the plane, and the system is unstable because not all the terms in the first column have the same sign. Okay, so guys, this was Routh Hurwitz criterion. If you like the video, do share, like, and do everything which you do, and guys, I will love if you have any doubt, you will post them in the comment section. But before ending the video, I will tell you one important thing. The Routh Hurwitz criterion has not been taught fully. Okay, so in the next video, I will do more questions on Routh Hurwitz criterion, which will cover Routh Hurwitz criterion in detail. So do watch that video. Thank you guys for watching the video.